Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this keynote speech about the application of RFID sensing technology to the industrial world. My name is Cecilio Chiuzzi. I'm an assistant professor at the University of Rome Tor Vergata and co-founder and CEO of RadioSense, a spin-off of our university aimed at proposing RFID sensing solution into the real world. Before going on with our speech, I would give you some details about my university and my research group. The University of Rome Tor Vergata is located in the neighbor, in the south neighbor of the city of Rome, in a very peaceful area. It is a college, and we have more or less all the faculties from humanities to the School of Medicine and Surgery. My research group, I work in the research group of the Pervasive Electromagnetic Lab, held by Professor Gaetano Marrocco. RadioSense is a kind of interface between the academia and the real world, and we have between the lab and the company more or less 10 scientists working with us. Today we will talk about industrial IoT. This is the picture of our conference in which a smart city is represented. Well, when we talk about industrial IoT, we took all the concepts of the smart city and we bring them to the industrial world. So we start talking about the smart factory. The industrial Internet of Things has the aim to optimize the manufacturing processes throughout interconnection of machines, generation of data, predictive maintenance, predictive monitoring. So the possibility to customize the production in order to improve the experience of the customer and the experience of the producer. The application field of these concepts are several. Probably the most impacted area is the manufacturing, but we have also many applications in energy and utilities and also in automotive sector. It is a revolution. Industrial IoT, or Industry 4.0 is considered all over the world the fourth industrial revolution. So from the first one in which we start using machinery, now we are asking more to this machinery. So we are asking to somehow to have information, to interact with them. So in addition to the big business implication of this revolution. Today, I would like to discuss with you three features that are important for the RFID. The first one is the multidisciplinary. The second one is the strong interconnection between physical and digital world. And the third one is the connectivity. So the industrial IoT involves many, many different skills, many, many different topics. We start from materials to arrive to electronics, mechanic, control, to develop a system for industrial IoT. We need to take into account all this stuff. And I like to think, but I'm not the only one, that think that probably electromagnetics and more specifically RF, it's a kind of glue that put together all these competence. The other stuff I want to discuss is about the connection between physical and digital world. So thanks to sensors spread over the industrial environment, we can gather information about the factory. And so we can create a kind of digital twins for the site. But the other jump, the other step we have to do is to go back to the to the physical world by imposing decision, by imposing strategies, by imposing modification in the factory structure and the factory function. And in these two stuff, RFID can give us benefits. So let's talk about the connectivity. This is an old picture I used more or less 5, 6, 7 years ago to talk about IoT. Here you have the application. So in the upper part of the tree, you have the application, the IoT, so smart city, logistics, retail, smart energy. And in the root of the tree, you have instead the connectivity platform. You can recognize Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, Zigbee, and also RFID. Well, at that time, but also now, RFID was considered for logistics, access control, tracking and trace, but probably the most important features of RFID related to the industrial world is the sensing capabilities. Well, what does it mean RFID in IoT? In our idea, thanks to the RFID, we can move from a wireless sensing infrastructure to a wireless sensor network with batteryless and low power devices. So from this kind of scenario to this one, in which we cannot only do better sensing measurement, but we can do something that otherwise we cannot do with the wired infrastructure. For example, monitoring object in movement in harsh environment. In order to realize this scenario, we have to improve the capabilities of RFID tag. In particular, we have to pump UHF tag in order to have, in addition to the only ID, also the state of the object where the tag is attached on. So we have to add to the labeling features also the sensing features. So in this scenario, we can imagine that passive batteryless sensor tags can be integrated within object and dispersed into the environment and over machinery. So something like this that benefits of a unitary and standard reading platform, because we have a standardized communication protocol that can be used for both sensing and identification. We can enable multiple service at low cost because we don't need complicated or heavy infrastructure to read RFID sensor. Since they are batteryless, they require low maintenance and they are highly reconfigurable because very quick, I will show you later on during my speech, that very quick you can move your monitoring platform from an object to another one without impacting too much to the manufacturing infrastructure. So, from the user, the final user sides, it's possible to benefits of fast implementation, high acceptance, moderate or low investment, and low impact on the sides. I would just give you a quick overview about the role of RFID sensing in scientific production. In this key phrase analysis that you can do by using Sheval, you see that related to radio frequency identification up to 2019, there were some words related to sensing or sensor system or IoT that start appearing without a big impact. But if you looked at the growth of these, for example, the word sensor together with the radio frequency identification device, you see that in the last 2 years, there is a strong growth of these fields. And this means that RFID sensing is still a very interesting topic also for scientific world. Well, when we talk about RFID sensing, basically we consider two topologies of sensor. One is the analog sensing, so we can use every antenna as a transducer, and in this way we use also the RFID tag. Otherwise, we have the digital sensing, so we use the antenna only for communication, and we exploit the new capabilities added to the RFID IC in terms of internal sensor or analog digital interface. Regarding the analog sensor, as I told you, it is related to the fact that every antenna is affected by the surrounding environment. So it changes its impedance or gain according to the variation of the boundary condition that it feels. This one is the video of the first experiment we did in 2008 in our lab. We took RFID label, the standard one, and we put it on a box containing sugar. Then we use an RFID reader to monitor the RSSI received by this reader during the flowing of the sugar inside the box. So somehow we relate the RSSI received by the reader to the filling level. And as you can see, there is a strong correlation between the filling level and the power received by the reader. And this was, at that time, the basis of our activity on the analog sensing approach. Okay, the analog sensing approach is extremely easy. Is extremely low cost, it's extremely promising in terms of application of the tag into the environment, because it's easy, basically it's easy. However, since it is an analog approach, it suffers high uncertainties and noising effect from the environment, and especially in real scenario, so especially in factories, especially in real world, it suffers of low resolution, accuracy, and precision. So it can be used for monitoring, for example, processing evolution, which have two or three important states, but it's not well performing when we look for high resolution or the detection of very small variation. Instead have sensors that can offer high performance in a very specific way, we have to consider the digital sensor tag. With this term, I mean RFID tag that include IC, with in addition to the RF front end, the memory, and the power unit, they have internal sensors, for example, the temperature one, and also analog front-end interface in order to connect external sensors, analog or digital, in case we have also an SPI port. In addition to this, for working in the proper way, we need also a microcontroller and an ADC converter. These IC are present in on commerce, so it's possible to buy this kind of IC that opened extremely interesting scenario in the industrial world, because they work as a thin computer. So the idea is that we are moving the computational capability to the object, so to the real world. Something in the middle between the analog sensing and the digital sensor that is extremely robust, extremely performing, is the possibility to get information about at the IC level about some digital metrics. So metrics that give us information about the mismatching of the RFID tag respect to its reference condition, because, for example, the environment changes. And new generation RFID IC has these capabilities. So in particular, they are able to digitally transform the analog information related to the impedance mismatch to a code that can be properly used to have information about the object where the tag is attached on. The interesting news for industrial IoT is that now it's possible to have commercial object that performs digital sensing activity. So it's possible to buy from two or three companies, an American one and also a European one, RFID sensors that can be interfaced to many external sensors. So for example, today we are able to measure through an RFID tag moisture, orientation, temperature, pressure, loads, and also, in particular, there is a strong and important industrial improvement in having tags that are ready to be applied in real world, and they are able to measure the temperature in different objects or in different conditions. So we have tag for metal, tag for dielectrics, tag for rotating part. This is extremely important because now we have the possibility to very quickly install monitoring architecture in factory. This is not always possible because sometimes you have to design the entire radiating part. So you have to customize your tag, that again is an RFID, so you have an antenna and an IC, but you have to customize the shape, the material, and the manufacturing process in order to be compliant with the object you want to monitor. And we will see later on how it's important to have a performing object in terms of communication, sensing, but also manufacturing. The same for the reader. You have a plethora of readers that are available on commerce, from fixed to readers that can fly over drones or can move over robots, that can be handled or wearable. So you have a kind of smartwatch that give us the possibility to interact with the tag spread in the environment. Again, you can use these object without modification, or sometimes you have to redesign the radiating part of the reader in order to be compliant with the process you want to monitor, with the infrastructure you want to monitor. The last part of the IoT, industrial IoT ecosystem, is related to the transmission of data from reader to the control infrastructure of the factory, for example, the SCADA system, the control unit, and then the processing of the data you get from the tag. So it's extremely important to complete the path that from data generation give us information by using, for example, the new gateway, IoT gateway, for example, LoRa, Sigfox, or the 3G or 4G network, and also exploit the cloud capability. So they perform a kind of data-driven analysis. So today, it's possible to interface RFID system with several protocols in order to transform the RFID reader and the RFID platform in one of a kind of add-on of the existing factories intelligence system. Okay, let's go now through the approach of the RFID sensing. if we have an RFID reader and RFID sensor tags, we can perform the monitoring of the plant or perform the monitoring of the object in production. So in the first case, we have to imagine RFID sensors spread over machineries, and what we get is the real-time plant data. So the information about the functioning of the plant in that moment. Otherwise, we can put RFID sensor into the object, embed it into the object, or attach it on the object, and have a kind of item level qualification. When we perform plant monitoring, as I told you, we have sensors over machinery that are read by an RFID reader. So we have a kind of function of the operation of the machinery depending on different parameters we want to monitor. So we have the real-time plant data that must be compared through a PLC, through a programmable logical control, with the reference optimal plant data. So by evaluating the difference between the ideal plant data with what we get at that moment, we can modify the functioning of the machinery by, for example, increasing the temperature, decreasing the temperature, speed up the procedure, and so on. So a real-time control of what happened to the machinery. Now I give you an overview about the most interesting application of this approach that we did in the last years. For example, this is a project in which we monitor the temperature of engine components during manufacturing. So we put RFID sensor tag in many parts of the engine in order to have information, for example, about the cooling system, about the heating of cables, so evaluate the insulation of the high voltage cables, but also by using RFID tag connected to external high temperature sensor, we were able to measure the temperature inside the engine part. Everything with a single one or two reader properly placed in the environment. This was an interesting example because, first of all, the manufacturer measured the temperature in place where usually it didn't do. So, for example, in the wings of the cooling system or on the cables. Then all these monitoring setup was installed very quickly without impacting on the production line, without impacting on the normal activity of the plants. This is another interesting project in which we were asked to monitor the state of a filter press. A filter press is a huge machine that is 15 meters long, in which fluids from chemical treatment enter into a series of filters in order to be filtered and then exit with some particular feature. Well, the problem is that very often this filter breaks, so it's necessary to monitor when this happens. And this can be related to the state of this pipe that usually are empty. Instead, when the filter fails, they are filled with water. So what we did was to put an RFID sensing label on this on each pipe. There are almost 150, 180, and with an architecture of array reader placed on the upper part of the machine, we monitor every in real time temperature and also the sensor code in order to have information about the insertion of a fluid into the pipe. And this is a monitoring that usually the manufacturer doesn't do because it's expensive to put thermocouple or to put a wire sensing system for each cable. But RFID enables this predictive maintenance monitoring. This is another interesting project in which we measure the temperature profile inside a rotating elements of a blast chiller. We are here in the ice cream production area, and the problem was that they need to measure the temperature profile inside a closed metallic box in which there is the ice cream. So during the movement, the producer recognized that there were some problems related to different thermal gradient that impact on the functioning of the machine, so in the energy consumption, in the noise, but also in the quality of the ice cream. So we put these passive label on the wings, and we measure from outside because the tags, even if they were closed in a metallic cavity and embedded into fluids, into liquid, were readable from outside thanks to this dielectric part. And so we were able to do a thermal map of what happened inside the blast chiller in real time. So the producer was able to control the thermal distribution, but also the effect of the different refrigerating cycle. So he was able to, for example, modify this cycle in terms of number, duration, and also energy. Another interesting project was about the rotating blades in paper industry. In paper industry, there are these blades that continuously cut paper. The problem is that the wear of these blades is extremely strong, so they have to change this blade very often. And if they don't change the blade in time, all the production of the paper fails. So sometimes they overestimate this wearing process, so there is a waste of the blade. So we put that several sensors of the RFID sensor on this blade. And what we did was to measure the thermal profile during the exercise. And as you can see, as expected, during the rotation, during the functioning, there is an increase of temperature. But this increase of temperature is related to the wear status of the blade. So for the first time, the producer was able to predict the failure point of the blade and change it in time. Okay, now let's go to the monitoring of the product. When you decide to use RFID tag for monitoring the product in manufacturing, so in production, you can do something that is extremely new for the RFID world, that is the idle level qualification. So what happens usually in production is that in the entire production they took samples and they perform some tests. So they don't have the control that each piece they produce has the good quality, as the right performances. So instead, by applying an RFID sensor tag directly into the object, it's possible to follow the item from the beginning up to the customer And this is with a kind of certified quality profile. So again, this time you have the RFID embedded into the object and interrogated by an RFID reader. So you have the function of the object that is compared through the PLC with some reference functions. Again, according to this comparison, you can act on the machinery in order to change the feature of the production. Again, increasing the temperature, slowing the time, speed up some procedure, and so on. So the idea is that thanks to this approach, is the object itself that controls its production. That is a paradigm that is completely new respect of what we did in the past. So as I told you, the result is to have an item level qualification. Okay, probably the monitoring of the product is more challenging for several reasons. First of all, the object, the tag can be embedded or attached into the object. So you have to design and adopt a tag that is compliant with the object that has to host it. Secondly, the object respect to the machinery can be in motion or can be fixed. So in the first case, you have only a quick reading window that you have to explode in order to have information about the production, or otherwise you have the monitoring of the whole process. And these fourth features can be randomly mixed. And so the design of an RFID platform that monitor the product is particularly challenging. Probably the most interesting project we did in this sense is the monitoring of conveyor belts. Everybody knows what is a conveyor belt. So you have this long rubber belt that is used in mineral world, in heavy factories to, for example, bring materials, to carry materials. The conveyor belts is done by proper attachment of different parts, for example, this pocket that carry the material, through vulcanization. So each piece is put close to another one and then it undergoes to a thermal solicitation in order to cure this joint and have the perfect adhesion between parts. However, this vulcanization is not completely standardized. So what happened is that sometimes the conveyor belt is overcured or sometimes is undercured. This means that you have, as the final for the final product, a poor performance of the object, sorry. So it is necessary to monitor that each piece of the conveyor belt undergoes the right thermal treatment. And this is what we did. We adopt the approach of sensorless tag embedded into the layers of the conveyor belts. By integrating an RFID reader into the curing press, we were able to follow the profile of the tag inside the rubber and control the duration of the curing or the temperature applied by the press. And so the result is that each piece of the conveyor belt is certified with a good production process. So with extremely great benefits in terms of performance of the object, safety of the object, but also energy saving and optimization of the production activity. These are other applications of this approach. For example, we were asked to monitor the maturation of precast elements in tunneling construction. This is a similar problem similar to the one of the conveyor belt. In order to speed up the production of the precast, concrete undergoes to a kind of cooking, a kind of heating. And the temperature is an important indicator of the performance. And so we design a tag that is capable to be implanted into the concrete, and thanks to this antenna element, transmit data, measured temperature data that it takes inside the concrete to an external reader. And this way we can increase the temperature, the heater temperature, decrease it, or speed up or slow down the velocity of the carousel where they are cooked. The same approach can be used in energy efficiency of building. For example, you can spread this tag into buildings and study the different temperature during the year. So in order to optimize the heater, optimize the cooling system, optimize the design itself of the building. Or probably that one is the most different one. We apply this technology to smart packaging in the food industry. So we are able, thanks to a proper merge of artificial intelligence, RFID tag, and cloud computing, we were able to produce a system that give us information about the ripeness of the fruit. So the ripeness in this case of avocado and mango. So as you have seen, there are many applicative scenarios, many possibility for RFID into industrial world. However, there are some challenges that cannot be neglected. These challenges regard both communication and sensing and manufacturing. Let's start with the communication and sensing feasibility, and in particular, the role of the temperature. Traditional industrial and civil electronics can withstand temperature up to 60-85 degrees. Well, when you are in the industrial world, these temperature are not enough. I mean, they are the starting temperature for industrial processes. So it's necessary to understand, to evaluate the operability of the RFID tags in high temperature environment. Why? Because the temperature can affect the sensitivity of the microchip, the impedance of the microchip, but also the sensing interface and the input-output interface. For example, when you put an RFID tag into a warm environment, what you experience is that according to the temperature, there is a strong decrease of the reading performance. So as the temperature goes becomes high, your tag start performing bad. In particular, the sensitivity increase very much. So the link budget that we try to control in order to be sure that the tag is readable must be evaluated not only at the beginning of the operation, but also during the operation. And so we have to take into account into our design of the detrimental effect of the temperature. Another problem of temperature is related to the sensor's output. We experienced that up to 70-90 degrees, usually conventional RFID IC that integrates internal sensor or integrates external temperature sensor perform well. The problem is that as we go through the higher temporal, that there is a shift of the output, so a non-linear and not monotonic drift of the output data. So before using this tag, these sensors in industrial environment, you have to correct this behavior by applying, for example, additional calibration curve in order to, as we did in this experiment, in order to have post-calibration error less than an acceptable post-calibration error. I just want to say that RFID tag can survive up to 150-160 degrees. They usually stop responding when they reach this temperature, but as soon as the temperature goes down these limits, they start answering again. So they are very robust against the temperature in terms of fails, in terms of operation. Another problem related to the industrial world is what happens when I have to monitor a tag, so an object that is in motion. For example, here you have the RSSI and the temperature retrieved from a tire that is rotating up to 300 kilometers or 5,000 RPM. As you can see, due to the motion and due to the also the EMC problem related to the engine that moved this object, you have a very confused distribution of the response of the tag. So you have to act on the signal processing, on the settings of the reader, and the optimization of the network, also in terms of shielding, because otherwise the information that you get is completely jeopardized. And so having this data, it's different from what usually traditional RFID users expect. Similarly, you have to solve the shielding problem in case you have to monitor an object into a closed cavity, for example, as in this case with the Turing press machine. What you have to do is to design the reader antenna right into the object right into the production site in order to get information from the embedded tags. And this can be done with the help of computer simulation that in this case is extremely important. The last thing I want to say is about the mechanical stress. Usually when you think about RFID, you think about a label that is placed over a box, over a plastic container, so something that is static and not subjected to strong mechanical solicitation. However, if you want to use RFID into industrial world, you have to design an object that is industrial. So you have to design an object that is capable to withstand high temperature, high mechanical solicitation, high speed, deformation. And this is a completely new approach respect to traditional RFID. And for example, what it's common to experience is that during the operation, so during the working of this tag into the object, there are fatigue phenomena, so cracking of the trays, parts of the antenna breaks, and so on. So you have to overcome the wear of the embedded device by adopting design and manufacturing processes that are typical of the industrial world. So, in conclusion, the RFID for Industry 4.0 is feasible. The technology is ready to be applied in real scenario, but you have to be sure to have the control of hard and unconventional electromagnetic phenomena. You have to considering that the manufacturing issues are far from standard RFID and that the required performance must to be compared with traditional wired sensors that are, even if they are old. And this last point gives us probably the most important open challenge up to now. So the typical maximum sampling rates of industrial acquisition system is around 100 kilo sample per second or 1 mega sample per second. At the moment, the RFID in the UHF band offers interrogation frequencies up to 1020 Hertz. So there is not possibility to compare with standard acquisition system. So how to solve it? For example, some interesting results are obtained by colleagues in UK by adopting BAP solution. So thanks to a particular RFID IC and a complicated electronic architecture, they were able to read a sensor tag up to 300 Hertz, sorry. That is extremely good results. However, this approach up to now is not enough to arrive to the industrial standard, but also it's expensive, it's not so robust to be applied in industrial scenario. So, the problem is still open. In the last couple of years, my group starts studying the possibility to have high frequency backscattering system. So the possibility to exploit the, let's say, radio frequency identification based on backscattering also in the 5G frequency. So what we expect is that we can benefit of all the features, or at least part of the features that characterize 5G systems. So high data rate, low latency, larger bandwidths, wide scale interoperability, and reduced antenna size. We don't mean that we want to use communication 5G systems also for RFID. No, we mean that probably it could be interesting to exploit the possibility to design backscattering system at higher frequency. And why not use RFID, 5G personal device, 5G wireless access, 5G wearable, smartphone, and so on and so forth, for interacting also with RFID or passive objects. There are some colleagues that start thinking about that. They did interesting studios at 60 gigahertz, but at the moment we don't have the electronics to experiment that. We are doing some preliminary evaluation in the lab. And we did it in particular by considering the human body monitoring through epidermal antenna. So the possibility to gather information about our health state by sampling our skin. And preliminary, very easy analysis on the signal-to-noise ratio by considering valid some assumptions that are now true for UHF RFID system, we theoretically envisage that we can arrive easily at 3.6 gigahertz, that is the lowest 5G band, one of the lowest 5G frequencies, we could arrive to 0.5 gigabit per second. At the moment, UHF system show data rates up to 600. So it's an order of, it's 600 kilobits. So it's it could be an extremely interesting approach. So I conclude my presentation. I'm here for question and answer. I want again say thank you to the research group in which I work, Professor Gaetano Marrocco, and all the guys that work with us, that even in this very particular period stay strong, and they give us enthusiastic support for going on. So thank you very much.